made it to Thailand. I'm alive. Made it out of the airport. Didn't manage to get a local SIM card at the airport, so I've got no internet on my phone. And surprisingly to me, the kind of subway line going from the airport into the city didn't have any maps of the city, so I didn't even know which subway stop to get off at. So my initial reaction was to get kind of peeved, thinking like, oh, they should have a map here. And then I realized that I was doing that thing where when my expectations don't match up with reality, I get peeved off at reality instead of like recognizing the falsity in my assumptions, my expectations, and adjusting. But I vaguely figured it out. So I got off at what I'm fairly confident is the correct subway stop. And then since I don't have like an Uber app or anything like that that I can utilize in Thailand at the moment, you know, no mobile internet, I'm just walking from the subway to the hostel. So it's not an awesome start, but I know I'm definitely less frustrated at this experience than a lot of people I know would be at this experience. So like even with doing research in advance, you know, like figuring out what kind of SIM card to get, and then like printing up papers for where I needed to go and stuff, even with all that, it wasn't sufficient to get me to the place I needed to go easily and successfully. Because even the info I printed up, you know, they said like what metro line to take, but it doesn't show a map of where that is in the city in relation to this like special airport subway line. Day one in Bangkok. My mission so far has been to find a local SIM card for my phone so that I will be able to navigate and find things, you know, figure out which bus to take, call a cab, etc. Even when I don't have Wi-Fi. Everything that I read online said that I should get a SIM card through this company AIS, which is like one of the three big telephone service providers in Thailand. And you know, from what I read, it says you can just get one either at the airport, which I tried, but they only had the tourist packages, which are a bit expensive. And you can also get them at any 7-Eleven. I've been to four 7-Elevens so far. The first person at a 7-Eleven just kind of shook their head and pointed out and to the side, indicating I should go that way and look. The next person at a 7-Eleven, you know, I went to a different 7-Eleven, asked the person behind the counter there. They said, no. You know, in English, because I don't really speak Thai. The next person shook her head and she pointed kind of across the street at an angle and said, shopping center. Shopping center doesn't open until 10 a.m. And then the fourth and the final one, she shook her head and she said, finish. Which I think is just her way of saying, like, no, we don't have it that, or no, we're out of that. So, at 10 o'clock, I'll go in the shopping center and take a look. But until then, I'm going to go to this little museum-ish place, which is actually the home of an American who worked for the CIA in Thailand. And he apparently gathered a lot of Thai things. You know, saying artifacts makes it sound overly anthropological or archaeological. But yeah, that's what it is. He just gathered a lot of stuff and built an interesting looking place. So I'm gonna check it out. We'll be right back. I keep forgetting how to say thank you in Thai. It is khop khun krap. And every time I need to say it, I forget how to say it. So I just kind of put my hands in that sort of prayer namaste thing that Thai people do. And do that instead. I can only assume that Jim Thompson, this CIA guy who built this house, I can only assume that he did some kind of smuggling or some kind of corruption, because this is a pretty big place for one civil servant or one bureaucrat to own and to build. So I'm guessing he had some kind of sponsorship or a lot of money coming from somewhere. One thing I was wrong about, I assumed that he had some kind of corruption or bribery or something to get so wealthy, but apparently he was just a really successful businessman. Jim Thompson kind of nurtured and cultivated the Thai silk industry for international export, and it was something that had been previously untapped. Apparently he took a bunch of the silk to the United States and showed people from fashion magazines, and it just boomed, it took off. Made lots of money as a result. I'm a bit frustrated with Uber at the moment. I've got my SIM card for Thailand, so I have a Thai phone number. I can use the internet. I've got mobile data. So I was gonna get an Uber to like this temple that I was gonna go see. And apparently I have to open up a web browser and go to the Uber site and send some special request to change the phone number associated with my Uber account. Which is really irritating because I haven't changed my payment information or anything else. But it's definitely a barrier for travelers. Kind of wish I'd known about that beforehand. I'm getting hungry. I slept in a little town called Krabi, K-R-A-B-I, and this morning, early in the morning, I got on a bus, going to be taking it eastward to an island, where I'm going to spend the next few days doing this diving course. It's a course in free diving, and let's see, I think I left Krabi at like 7 a.m. I should arrive in this, well, on this diving island maybe around 3 o'clock or so. I also may have lost my passport, which is gonna be a bit of an adventure in itself. I hope that it's just buried in a pocket somewhere, or perhaps that the front desk at the place I slept last night forgot to give it back to me. I left a note for them, and they can just mail it to the next place I'm staying. Otherwise, I think my vacation will be extended by a week or so, because I'll have to apply for a new passport at the American Embassy in Bangkok. I just spent the last couple hours on a bus. We're at kind of a pit stop at the moment. I noticed behind me there's these kind of action figures, like Transformer kind of things, which are vaguely cool, I guess. I made it. I'm on the island of Koh Tao. I'm on a beach, which is really nice beach, I guess. Heading over to grab some dinner at a local place, and hopefully I found information online about a local yoga school studio. So I'm gonna go over there and do some of that. I've just finished the first day of this course I signed up for on how to learn to do free diving. Free diving is diving in the water, but there's no scuba gear. There's no, it's basically just you in the water. You can have fins, and we use these little goggle things. We did some dives with fins on our feet and some without. So, that was nice. It was a good experience. I'm not the most comfortable in the water, but I'm feeling a lot more comfortable now than I was 4 hours ago. I think I went down to 10 meters or 12 meters, which that's farther than I've ever been down before. That was cool. And then tomorrow we might go down a bit deeper. Yeah, but there's these breathing techniques for relaxation. That's about all there is to it, really. So I'm gonna grab some food. I'm starving. I'm so hungry. The sun is pretty strong on this island. I have spent half of yesterday and half of today in the water doing free diving. And I've got the very specific markings to show for it. We wore these kind of, not really snorkel masks, but it's kind of, well, I guess they're free diving masks. It's kind of goggles. But they also cover your nose, and this is right where the edge of it was. I just arrived at my room, my hostel, my bungalow in Koh Phangan. The island of the infamous full moon party, which I will definitely not be attending. I'm on the opposite side of the island and got a fantastic view of the sea. Kind of jungle treetops there and the ocean down beneath it. So this is where I'll be staying for the next 2 days or 2.5 days. I arrived at Tantawan bungalows an hour or two ago. I kind of unpacked my things, sat down in my room. I've been googling around and researching for different yoga schools and things I can do in this part of the island. But the place I'm staying at is really cozy. Not only do I have a very cute little room and a lovely view of the sea, the restaurant's pretty nice and I've got it to myself. There's not a single other person in here. And the owner, a Belgian guy and his wife, who run this place for the past year and a half, very friendly, giving recommendations, so I'm pretty pleased. I'm just gonna sit tight here today. For tonight, I'm just gonna have dinner and sit tight here at this little bungalow hotel place. And then tomorrow, I think I'm gonna rent a scooter and go to a yoga class in the morning, do some kind of exploring and scooting around during the middle of the day, and then I think another yoga class in the evening. I arrived on Koh Phangan last night, and that means today is my first full day on the island. I'm gonna rent a scooter, explore, go to a yoga class, find some place for lunch, just kind of, explore and look around. I've got the scooter for the whole day, so I'll see what I can find.
I am pretty excited because for the first time ever, someone has approached me and started speaking to me in a non-English language because of my shirt. I'm wearing my Fluent in 3 Months shirt, and on the back it says, oh, speak to me in this language. So it has Chinese written in Chinese, and it has Spanish written in Spanish, and it has Portuguese written in Portuguese. And somebody just kind of walked up to me and said, like, hola, ¿cómo estás? And at first I was kind of shocked and surprised because it had never happened before. But then I realized, oh yeah, this woman just read my shirt. Which is kind of cool. Next several days, this is going to be my office. This is going to be my working space. I am at Co Space, which is a co-working space right on the beach.
I'm walking along the beach on the southwestern side of Koh Phangan. I'm staying at an Airbnb which is run by a co-working space over here called Co Space, actually. It's pretty simple, just a single room and like a nightstand and a like cabinet for clothes. Not even an attached bathroom, it's like a shared bathroom. But because it's a co-working space, out in the common area, you know, they've got tables, they've got good Wi-Fi. I didn't feel very good most of the day, kind of a headache, stomach ache sort of thing. Not totally sure why, but I'm feeling a bit better now. I spent most of the day either watching videos I had downloaded from YouTube or going through Python practice. One of the things I've been trying to do recently is to learn a bit of Python. Python is a programming language, and it's a pretty good language for beginners to learn because it's relatively easy. I'm still struggling a good deal with it. I find a lot of it pretty challenging. Anything worth doing is pretty challenging. And then, let's see, other than that, a lot of the YouTube videos I've downloaded, they are kind of tutorials, they're like learning how to do things kind of videos. You know, a few of them are just general entertainment, sort of like cultural critics talking about various things. But as far as the learning ones go, so a lot of things computer focused, like downloading some videos about asymptotic notation, which is a pretty new concept to me, which I'm having difficulty grasping, and then very specific technical things, like in Python, how to find if one string is present in another string, you know, things that for somebody who knows Python are really, really simple, but for me as a beginner, I need reminders and need refreshers on how to do that kind of stuff. But I feel it's been pretty productive. It's been good. And I figured, you know, I've just been sitting in my room all day or sitting in the co-working space all day, typing away my laptop. I figured I'd come out, have a stroll along the beach, maybe find something for dinner. Actually, definitely find something for dinner. I don't want to go to bed on an empty stomach. But yeah, the weather's lovely. I can see a nearby island across the water. I'm trying to kind of show a little bit in the framing the beach. The beach is pretty nice, not the best one I've seen. You know, but certainly nice enough to justify a pleasant evening stroll. All right, that's about all I've got to say.
There are some decently nice places here. As luck would have it, although I was going to do a bicycle tour today, and a group of us were going to go see like a coconut processing plant and like how they harvest rubber from rubber trees. Instead, I ended up having a tummy ache and vomiting and just not feeling well at all. So I'm here in the local hospital. It seems like nothing serious, just food poisoning. So I'll stay here for a few hours, which is kind of a bummer. Not only a bummer in the sense that I'm kind of like woozy and I've got a bit of a headache, but also in the sense that I'm just losing so much time. Like there were things I was going to do today and now I can't do them, which is annoying. But I think once I'm feeling a little bit better, what I will do is I'll go back to the place I'm staying and grab all of my stuff and kind of check out of there and just bring that over here so that at least I'm going to spend the night at the hospital. So at least I won't be sitting here bored out of my mind. At least I could, like, read my book or, like, watch a movie on my laptop or kind of do something to keep my mind occupied. You know, I've been getting antibiotics and, like, medication for the pain. Yeah, I'm feeling fine now.
I'm sitting in the hospital, feeling a lot better than I was a couple of hours ago. I was brought a menu for dinner, and I kind of want to show you something that I think is really funny. You can order a beer on the hospital's menu, which I'm not going to do, but merely the mere thought of that is something that I find to be kind of funny.
Successfully arrived on the island of Koh Lanta. It was a pretty long day of travel on boat and ferry and bus and minibus and another boat, not in that order. And I've arrived on the island of Koh Lanta, and I got in touch with the co-working space, and this is the, I guess you could vaguely call it a studio apartment or maybe like a two-room apartment that I'm going to be staying in. It's fairly bare, but that's okay because I have a pretty simple aesthetic, and it's also fairly big, which I kind of like. I enjoy the open space. And I'm also, probably tomorrow I'll go and check out the co-working space here, which I'm pretty excited for. Massages over there. This is kind of a beach bar and restaurant, and got a pretty sunset.
It was lovely to be able to sit down and get some work done.
Today's Saturday, so I'm not doing work for the company I work for. I'm doing like work on my own projects. But it was so nice to have like a desk and a chair and high-speed internet and non-censored internet. So that was really nice. You know, caught up on a couple of tasks I had that I hadn't done in a little while, and then made some progress on some other stuff. A good deal of research, a little bit of language practice, a decent amount of like coding practice with Python. And then it's about 4 o'clock, in about 20-30 minutes there's going to be a yoga class at one of these little pavilions behind me. So I'm just kind of going to stroll on the beach a little bit until that gets started.
For the week, I am working remotely here in Thailand on the island of Koh Lanta. This is my morning commute, walking along the beach for about 20 minutes to get from the Cohub apartments, where I'm sleeping, to the Cohub co-working space, where I'm doing my work. Not a bad morning commute, I'd say. Pretty pleasant.